हेलो नमस्ते, मैं हूं डॉक्टर सौरभ एंड वेलकम टू साइंसिया ब्रेनरी। यू माइट हैव हर्ड अबाउट एनिमल ह्यूमन कन्फ्लिक्ट, स्पेशली इफ वी टॉक अबाउट ह्यूमन एलिफेंट कन्फ्लिक्ट एंड दैट इज एस्केलेटिंग ड्यू टू लॉस ऑफ हैबिटेट एंड फ्रेगमेंटेशन ऑफ द हैबिटेट, डिफोरेस्टेशन और इंक्रीज इन द एग्रीकल्चरल लैंड। एंड दिस इज ए थ्रेट टू बायोडाइवर्सिटी कंजर्वेशन बिकॉज क्रॉप रेडिंग बाय द एलिफेंट्स, इट causes reciprocal losses of the life, means it causes the loss of both elephant life and human life. You see the current example of COVID-19 pandemic, actually what is happening? The destruction of biodiversity, deforestation in quest of infrastructure, development and economy enhancement. What is happening? We are going for the deforestation, we are going for the loss of natural habitat for the wildlife. And that is increasing the risk of pandemics, like you can see now the COVID-19 pandemic, because most of these diseases or pandemic, they are zoonotic. And you see in case of deforestation or loss of habitat, whatever the wildlife is conserving or saving, you can say surviving, like you see the example of bats, rats, actually they are the host of so many pathogens. And that's why these pathogens may jump from animal to humans. So you can see that this coronavirus, if you see the example, that is also the zoonotic disease. So this is another cause of, you can say that this is another cause of loss of biodiversity conservation or consequence of biodiversity loss, actually. So which is causing the incidence of such type of pandemics. And in that case, if you see currently that in this lecture, like we are talking about the animal human conflict, and that is mainly about the human elephant conflict, actually. So that is also escalating in across the world. If you see mainly the elephant habitat areas, if you see the example of Asia, Africa, and particularly in India also. Okay, so in this context, in today's lecture we will see that what are the means the measures or alternatives or methods, approaches which can be used to avoid the this animal human conflict. So in that case, one of the example is that the use of the beehive. So you can see that bees to save the humans from elephants, and bees to save the human from the elephants, or elephants from the humans, in both way actually. So we can say that the beehive, they may mitigate the human-elephant conflict. And what is this REHAV, Rehab Project? So we will discuss about all these things and how this is interesting, that how the bees, they can deter the human-elephant conflict, actually. So let's start the discussion. And if you see that, we can say that the elephants are a most intelligent animal. And about this human or animal conflict, if we talk about this, so according to WWF, which is World Wide Fund for Nature, so they have defined the human and wildlife conflict actually in a way that the human and animal wildlife conflict, or you can say the human and wildlife conflict, that can be defined as the any interaction between humans and wildlife that results in negative impacts of human social, economic or cultural life, means any interaction between humans and wildlife which causes negative impacts on human social, economic or cultural life and on the conservation of wildlife populations or on the environment. Okay, so you see that the both way losses are there, both way losses are there to humans also, the wildlife also, the biodiversity also. Okay, so generally if we say that in India only, if we see the example of India only, the elephants causes actually from dollars to $1,000 to $1,000,000 of losses by crop raiding actually. And if every year actually, if you see the 100 to 300 humans, people are died in actually in India every year due to this human elephant conflict. And on the other hand, in this conflict, 40 to 50 elephants are also actually killed during this human and animal conflict. So that's why it is important to mitigate this conflict, and we need to look for the innovative measures continuously to avoid this conflict, and for the conservation of biodiversity also, for the conservation of our farmland, for the security of our farmers also, for the security of our biodiversity and our animal wildlife also. So actually many measures have been adopted by the scientists during the course of time, and you can see that use of the watchover towers in the trees, trip wire alarms, okay, then radio collars, chilly smoke, and use of the bee. You can see this is the trip wire alarms and chilly smoke, okay, and use of the beehive fences, okay. So these are the different measures which are currently used by the scientists or conservationist to avoid the elephant human conflict, okay. But you see that elephants are also quite intelligent, and actually with the passage of time they get habituated to these deterrents, okay, over the time. So that's why we need to rotate these measures, or simultaneously we should also look for the other innovative measures to create a deterrence, okay, so that we can avoid this human and animal conflict. So in this context, actually, bhai, this is in news recently. So you see that this is the news of the Hindu in today's news only, actually 16th of March, the bee fences to ward off elephant attacks. And beehive fences, they can help mitigate human elephant conflict. So what has happened actually, and there is one association, that is Khadi and Village Industries Commission, which is in Karnataka state, and this is in the Karnataka state, okay. So they have launched a project, bee fences project to mitigate the elephant human conflict in the country, okay. So you see, if you see that this is pity for the big animal, that big animal, and against a small minute insect, if you see the example of bees against the elephant, okay. So actually in the Kodagu district of the Karnataka region, actually, so they have started this project, and this pilot project, and it has been in this pilot project, if you see, which has been launched in the Kodagu district of the Karnataka. And what is being done actually, so they are installing the bee boxes like this. So they are installing the bee boxes along the periphery of the forest areas and the villages, with the belief that elephants will not venture anywhere close to the bees, and that's why they can safeguard their agricultural land also, and they can deter the human elephant conflict also. So if you see that this idea stemmed from the concept that elephants, they are scared of the bees. So in this context, that's why that is discussing about the rehab project. So that's why this society, actually Khadi and Village Industries Commission of this Karnataka, they have started a project named rehab, means reducing elephant human attacks using bees, okay, and which I told you that they are going to install the bee fences to prevent the elephant attacks on human, okay, or to prevent the entry of elephants in the human settlement, okay. So actually, where is this project actually being launched in India? So if you see, as I told you, that it is in the Kodagu district of the Karnataka, and they have selected the four locations for this. And these four locations in Karnataka, they are located near the Nagarhole National Park and Tiger Reserve. Okay, so these four locations are located around this national park, and which is also known as Rajiv Gandhi National Park. So this, if we talk about this in brief, if I tell you about this Nagarhole National Park. So this park actually is derived from the word Naga, means snake, and hole, which refers to as streams. So this park is also known as the Rajiv Gandhi National Park, and it is located in the Kodagu and Mysore district of the Karnataka state, and the Kannada is the local language around this national park, okay. And if you see that this national park, it has been declared as 37th tiger reserve in India, and it is also considered as World Heritage Site by the UNESCO. Okay, so you remember about this park also, that it is also known as the Rajiv Gandhi National Park, located in the Kodagu district of the Karnataka, and it is also declared as the 37th Tiger Reserve in India. It is also a UNESCO World Heritage Site, and it is in this park, in the vicinity of this park, there are other parks like Bandipur, Mundu Malai, and Binad Wildlife Sanctuary. They are also in the vicinity of this park. Okay, and you can find different types of habitats or wildlife in this park, like Bengal tiger, Indian leopards, sloth bear, herbivores. If you talk about the herbivores, that you can find the elephants, chital, sambar deer, etc. Okay, so this was all about this Nagavare National Park. And let's come back to our today's lecture, that is elephant and human conflict. So like this, I was telling you about the this project, actually, which they have started, a rehab project by the this KVIC organization. So what they are doing, actually, they are installing 15 to 20 beehive boxes in these four locations, and to avoid the human elephant conflict, actually. Okay, so these boxes, actually, what is done, actually, these boxes, you can see that in the pictures. Actually, these boxes, they are connected with a string, and so that when the elephant, they try to, means when they try to pass through this this area, this fence, actually, so a tug which causes the bees to swarm the elephant herds, and to avoid the elephants to pass through. Okay, so to create a deterrence, actually, because the elephants are scared of the bees, and especially the sound of angry beehive. So in this what is done in this project, they are installing the cameras also on the trees, and these bees hives are also placed on the ground, as well as they are also hung from the trees. High resolution night vision cameras are also installed to note the activity or impact of the bees on the elephants and their behavior in these zones. So if we talk about the advantage of this project, this rehab project, so the biggest advantage, we can say that this is the natural way to avoid this animal human conflict, and we are not causing any harm to any life, whether it's human or elephant. Okay, and another is that it is also a cost effective measure, instead of compared to other measures like digging trenches or electric fences. So it is actually cost effective measures, use of the beehive fences, actually. So if you see that during the period of 2015 to 2020, nearly about 2,500 people, they have lost their lives in this human elephant conflict. And on the other side, about 170 human fatalities, they have been recorded in Karnataka state alone. So actually, from where this idea came, the idea of using of beehive fences, from where this idea originated, actually. So what is done, actually, and why these elephants are scared of honeybees, actually. So what happens that it is now well established that elephants, they are scared of the honeybees, and even a sound of angry swarm is enough to drive the elephant away. So actually, they are scared of honeybees because they fear that they may stung on their sensitive parts. If you see the example, like eyes, their face, their trunk, okay, so they can stung on their sensitive parts, actually. So that's why they are usually scared of this honeybees, especially if you talk about the Apis cerana indica. Okay, so this idea actually originated from the, if you see the concept of Dr. Lucy King. So she is Dr. Lucy King, and she is a zoologist. And the idea came from her project, actually. So actually, she is a zoologist, and one day she was intrigued by this concept. She heard about this thing that in Kenya. So she moved to Kenya, and she started a project, actually. And there Dr. Lucy King, she have heard that in Kenya, some farmers are doing this practice, actually. So what did she did? She actually set up a experiment or series of experiments with her colleagues. After visiting Kenya, she visited Kenya, and she started doing experiments and set up a series of tests or experiments with her colleagues, that to see that what about the bees, which was carrying the elephants. Okay, she wanted to see actually what was it that was carrying the elephants, and that means this, how, what about these honeybees which were scaring the elephants actually. So she set up a project in this Kenya and with her colleagues, and she came up here, and then she found that she found an interesting thing, that even just playing a sound of angry beehive, it was enough to drive the elephants away. And even a sound of means just a sound of angry beehive, that was enough to drive the elephant away. And actually they were scared of mainly of the stung, means they may be bitten, they may be bite by the bees, or you can say they may elephants, they are scared of that they be stung by the bees on their sensitive parts like eyes, mouth or the trunk. Okay, and she further said that this is actually a win-win situation, because we are saving both the lives, the animal life also, human life also, and that too in the natural way. And so this was actually a win-win situation, if you say that this is actually a win-win situation. Okay, so from her project actually this idea stemmed, and which with this, based on that, in India also, in the Karnataka, that rehab project, it was initiated. Okay, it was started to ward off the elephant human conflict. Then another advantage, if you see that like I told you, this is a win-win situation, both the lives are saved. Another advantage is this, it means you are installing the beehives, so it is good for the economic, for the poor farmers. See, one thing is that if you installing the beehives, that is good for the crops to pollinate, so they, you may, farmers may get high yield like that. So that is another example, another advantage, that they are the good pollinator worldwide, they are the best pollinator rather. Okay, so they can keep their crops, the farmers can keep their crops. Okay, so and the bees can pollinate them. And another thing is that poor farmers, they are, can also be benefited from the extra income. Extra income, how? That you are installing the beehives, so you can sell the, they can sell, they can get the extra income by selling the honey. So you can see that this is the project, elephant friendly honey. Okay, so like this project, this products or honey is sold, so this is also another source of extra income for the poor farmers. Okay, then another thing is that farmers, this is also the conserving the biodiversity also. Okay, means if you see that conservation of the elephants and avoiding the human elephant conflict, so we can say that this is in all way, this is a win-win situation, and it is beneficial for the both ecology, wildlife and humans, and economically also it is sound. This is also cost effective method, and it is also means an extra source of income also for the poor farmers. So in this way we can say that this is quite effective method, and 80% success. Although we should look for the other innovative mears also, and we should use all these mears in rotation actually, because elephants are also quite intelligent. So you can read, if you want to read about this publication of this Lucy King, Dr. Lucy King. So recently, in the 2018 article, it was published in the current biology journal. So you can find much more details regarding this thing, about this honeybees, how honeybees deter the elephants. So with the article that wild Sri Lankan elephants retreat from the sound of disturbed Asian honeybees. So this was all about the today's lecture. I hope you might have learned something new, and how we can avoid this elephant human conflict in the natural base and conserve our biodiversity, our wildlife and our farmers and our agricultural crops. Okay, so I would like to end to today's video with this, and I would say thank you, stay happy, stay blessed and stay safe. Please share, subscribe and like.